I want to bring in former McCain campaign director, Ford O'Connell, Democratic strategist Chris Hahn. Welcome to you both. So, Ford, what do you make of the continuation of Trump being combative versus Jeb Bush and certainly versus Senator Cruz?
Well, it plays right into his whole Make America Great Again. His whole deal is that I'm going to protect you, the voter, from D.C. I'm going to protect you from establishment Republicans. I'm going to tell you who's the fear, and I'm going to tell you who's going to fix the situation. I think it's brilliant TV, and you want to know what? He's winning, and he's probably going to win South Carolina with it.
Yeah.
Well, when he started to talk about Common Core and say, we will end Common Core, we are going to bring education locally, he said the U.S. is spending the most out of any other country, and we are 30th. On the list as far as education results. Chris, you just chimed in there. Is that issue one of the make or break ones for South Carolina?
Well, I think that it is a big issue in some primaries. Whether it's make or break in South Carolina, I don't think so. But I got to tell you, these rallies are very entertaining. Donald Trump is like a classic rock artist. He gives the people what they want every single time. The people there are now shouting his lines back at him. He's kind of got this movement thing going on right now, and that's really why he's winning. Some people like to say the guy's having fun on the campaign trail, and I think the people who are supporting him are having fun too, and that's why he's dangerous to the Republican Party, and he might
All right.
just be their nominee.
Speaking of dangerous, so Ford, what is Trump's Achilles heel? You ran a campaign, you know, what would you be telling him if you were working for him? Hey, look out for this.
Here's what Trump really has to worry about. Can one of the other candidates basically make the case that Trump is not a friend of the little guy, that he's not actually going to protect you, that he's not actually going to be able to do a lot of the things he says he does, and that he's really out for his own ego and self-interest? The idea is to pierce the veil that he's actually going to protect you, the little man, from the establishment, from D.C., from the drug companies, from terrorists, etc. Is Trump really out to help you, or is he really just out to help himself? That's the whole key.